Okay, we're back again, and we're going to see Ninjapan come up against
Canada.
Yeah, this is going to be a good one. Ninjapan had an amazing game earlier.
Yeah, for those of you that didn't watch that against Power of Scotland earlier, some of the skating style and just the sheer enthusiasm. Although, if you, those of you that did see it will understand what I mean when I say this, they need to get some better fitting panties.
Yes, they do need to get some better fitting panties. I think it was about twice the helmet panty pinged off.
Anyway, I'm King Crazy alongside...
Little Joker, back again.
Back again, having done one bout together already this morning.
Yep, hopefully we've got all the technical difficulties out the way. Yeah. Although my voice isn't working quite right at the minute.
Okay, so does that mean that you're not doing much and the poor people at home have just got to listen to me?
Yeah.
Okay. You lucky, lucky people. So, just a quick update. In this group, both teams have played one. Canada played Belgium and won that 255-20. Ninjapan played the Power of Scotland and lost 73-247. So basically where we stand is if Canada win this, they and Scotland will go into the quarterfinals tomorrow. And Japan, to have any hope of going into the quarterfinals, need to win this today. One thing they will not be lacking, and you may well hear this even on the live feed, is they will not be lacking in the crowd support.
Yeah, Ninjapan got the probably some of the biggest cheers in their game against the Power of Scotland. It's just their enthusiasm. I mean,
it is, yeah.
They really haven't been playing this game long. Well, speaking to Quadzilla, he said he was over in December teaching them the rules to the game because they play a different game.
Yeah, it's roller sports. Roller games,
which,
that's it.
I think in that every jam's a power jam.
Pretty much, yeah.
So now they're having to deal with two jammers on track. I think it's a little bit confusing, but...
And I will say right now, I apologise on behalf of myself and Joker for any pronunciations that we may not get quite right in this one. We'll try our best.
We'll do our best. Or if you want, we do have a different broadcast in a different language.
We do. For those of you who can speak Japanese, if you wish to listen to the Japanese feed, the alternate language feed for this bout is being done by Robert Rodriguez.
Yes.
I got that one wrong. What am I going to do with these names? and he does have the Japanese feed right now. So nice to see. Handshakes all around to start with. And first up for Team Canada, 0, El Tanant. And he's up against Nayugi Bondai, R4.
One of the hard names.
Yeah, one of the harder ones.
One of the harder names.
I don't know if you can see on the screen, but 1920 DJ Jack is approaching 60.
Well, you couldn't tell that out on track, though, the way he was skating in the first game.
I'm just wondering how many of these guys have appeared on Ninja Warrior, the way they skate, because I reckon they'd be really good at that as well.
Yeah.
But in the meantime, El Tanant straight through on the inside. He is your lead jammer. DJ Jack picks up a false start penalty, so he's the first one to visit the quad skate shop Bucks.
Ninjapan's jammer trying to get through, currently on that pivot line, which is sponsored by GB EMS, our lovely emergency services that are here today. El Tanant coming round for a scoring pass. And the crowd's going wild because Ninjapan's jammer has gone out.
Yeah, I'm sure you can hear this at home. It's going to be interesting. It's going to be loud. You two taking the style this time for Ninjapan. And I'll let you say the Canadian jammer's name.
Flustercluck.
That's going to go wrong at some point. I was really hoping he wasn't going to be a jammer.
Yeah. I saw his name earlier when I was walking around. He skated past and I was like,
oh dear.
Yeah, that's one of those names that you just don't want to say wrong.
So we have the final score from the other track. England 3:45, the Netherlands 22.
Flustercluck trying to get through, gets out, gets Lee Jammer out turn one.
You two having a tough time going through, but he blasts his way through. Bit of pure physicality. Out of play, cool. Titchborne has to let him go.
And round comes Flustercluck, pulls off the jam. So Ninjapan still to put any points on the board, but their jammers are getting out.
They are, they. Maybe they've had help from Fast Girl Skates, serving skaters of all shapes and sizes since 2007. Miyagi Bondi, R4 once more for Japan. And he's up against number 5, red for Team Canada. We have 3-on-2 in the pack in Canada's advantage. And straight up the inside, lead jammer. Big, big hit there. Couldn't see who that was. Was it Tank?
Tank, yep, that was M4. Tank knocking.
Tank by name, Tank by nature.
Yeah, knocking them to the inside. Some big guys on Team Canada.
In the meantime, Red's not worried. He's just going around, picking up 5 points, adding to the score.
Another heavy hit there. That's number 86.
That's Kent. That's another one we need to be careful with.
Yeah, we don't want to get too excited with that word. The Ninja Pans jammer trying to get out. Now they're in turn 3.
Having a tough time as Kent and Tank, as we've already identified in there, along with F22, Bradas. Or Bradas, is that meant to be? I'm not quite sure.
Team Canada taking Ninja Pan back into the start of turn 3 there. Out of play being called on, I think, is
Tank?
That?
No, sorry.
Kent.
Kent.
That was Kent.
The other one. And Miyagi Bondi still really trying at the front of the pack.
And Tank trying to force him out.
In case you can't tell, he's got through. Oh, there's all sorts going on here.
Red doing some kind of body bobbing to the inside there.
There was a penalty. I did see a penalty signal to one of the Ninja Pan skaters, but I didn't see who it was.
I didn't see who it was.
Here we go.
I did see the penalty, though. It was a direction of gameplay.
And it went to number 136. That is Zorro.
Now we have number 12, Walker, on the jam line for Team Canada. And U2.
So at the minute, yep, they've just realised just in time. Japan had one too many on.
Yep, Japan with too many blockers. They got one blocker in that penalty box.
You can only then have 3 on track. And lead jam once more goes to Canada. But U2 throws hot behind him. Little apex jump, 4 points, hit it and quit it. Green Monster Roller Sports, all new. Visit us today at greenmonster.com, and that's Green Monster without the vowels, GRNMNSTR.com.
Of course, if you like what you're hearing, you can drop us a few quid using the link on the broadcast page. It's split 50-50 between the broadcast crew and the teams competing, putting towards them travelling over here. A lot of the teams have come a hell of a distance.
Yes, well, we've got two of the teams here that have travelled a hell of a long way.
Yeah.
But he has got lead jam. I think it was U2. He was called lead jammer before he went down.
So Ninja Pan with lead jam. Team Canada with just 2 blockers in. Ninja Pan gets out. The crowd is going in full support.
And he did. I think he did it in time. Yes, he did. And he's thanking the crowd. He's waving to the crowd. Oh, the crowd here is absolutely fantastic. This is going to be a hell of a bout. Bearing in mind, yeah, what time are we on now? Just gone 4 o'clock, 6 hours worth of pretty much non-stop derby, and the crowd are still lively, the crowd still have the energy. Absolutely fantastic.
Oh, lovely bit of blocking there by number 7.
Umasan.
And Ninja Pan has got out and got lead again.
This is Miyagi Bondi, and it is Fluster Cluck that is chasing him down.
So now we're going to see Ninja Pan pick up some points.
I think we
are. Put some points on the board against Team Canada.
However, Fluster Cluck has just gone through completely unchecked on the inside.
Miyagi Bondi pouncing around, forced to the outside. He pulls it off.
3 points.
He's trying his best, bless him.
I'm really, really hope you guys can hear this at home. This is a fantastic atmosphere.
3 points on the board now for Ninja Pan. And we've got number 5, Red, up against U2. Born in Japan. We've got a 3-on-2. Red taking that outside line. Gets out, picks up Lee Jammer before he reaches that pivot line. U2 trying to find his way through. Just two blockers on there to try and help him out.
Trying to get some help. Bubble there. Number 99 was trying to give him some help. Big, big work from number 22, Ziggy. Forcing U2 all the way back. It's a demoralizing as a Jammer, that. Just about through. The North team going to go all the way back. Oh, there is a track cut penalty has been called on U2. We have a Canadian power jam.
U2 trying to jump around the outside there. Picks up that cut track.
And that allows Red to really rack up the points. As a failure to reform penalty has been given to one of the Japanese blockers.
Another grand slam courtesy of Red. Zoro going to the penalty box. Born in Japan. In comes Red. Nice, easy pass.
Manages to get around the outside. Cut track given there to number 99. That's Bubble. He'll make his way to the box. So just the two blockers on track. Number 32 is... Oh, this is one I'm going to struggle with. Ikagese Soyoro? Oh, yeah, number 32, we'll go with that.
Number 32.
Okay. I've had a go, that's about as good as it's going to get.
The Jammer for Ninjapan is standing in that penalty box waiting to come back out on track.
And right on cue, here he comes.
Team Canada are going to take him all the way back to the start of turn three before he can get back on.
Dr. T. Sanchez taking him all the way back.
Yeah, and Red calls it off as he enters the track.
And this next jam is brought to you by Roller Derby City, Europe's largest supplier of roller derby kit and merch. So I thank them for sponsoring this track, and Quad Skate Shop, who sponsored the penalty box here and the other track.
One of the other main sponsors.
So yes, big thank you to them for helping support, helping fund this tournament. Biggest tournament in men's derby, I think.
Yeah.
Certainly the most global. In the meantime, while we've been talking, Walker decides to fly through the inside, pick up lead jam for Team Canada. And I believe it's Miyagi Bondi once again trying to fight his way through for the Ninjapan team.
Four versus two, blocker advantage to Team Canada.
It just seems that the Team Canada was just winding him up. And just one after another, trying to take him out.
There's Unsan coming in with a heavy hit there, but just bouncing off of Walker.
Lovely move to get around the outside of Umisan. You almost see the look of frustration on Umisan's face then.
I don't know if the camera zoomed in on that. An easy pass for Walker. 5 points on the board for Team Canada. Team Canada up to 99 points.
Umisan making his way to the Quad Skate Shop penalty box as Walker takes the Canada pass, three figures. Miyagi Bondi having a real tough time. Walker's just doing laps out here at the minute.
I mean, Team Canada is proving to be such a fluid wall, recycling and just keeping Miyagi Bondi in that pack.
And Walker's just deciding where he wants to pick. Does he want to pick the outside? Does he want to pick the inside? He's going pretty much where he wants. Bradas forcing Miyagi Bondi all the way out, all the way recycled to the back. But he's not giving up. 10 out of 10 for effort. Really going for it.
And Team Canada just won a relentless wall, draining the energy of Miyagi Bondi for that full 2 minutes.
45 points picked up on that jam. So Fast Girl Skates offering unparalleled expertise, customer service and fast economical shipping. Visit us at www.fastgirlskates.com for league and military discounts. You two back on the jam line up against El Tanant. So 18 minutes to go, 124 plays three. I think with about like this, the score's kind of irrelevant. It's just enjoy it. Sit back, relax, enjoy it, and listen to the crowd. El Tanant has got through. He has picked up lead Gemma.
U2 trying to fight his way through, knocked to the outside of turn one. Taken all the way back past the pivot line.
But El Tanant went out as well and has done again.
Lovely bit of recycling by Ninjapan.
And that was show there, realising it had taken El Tanant out and he's gone for him again. Didn't get him that time. El Tanant makes his way through, picks up a 5-point pass. And a track cut called on U2. He makes his way to the penalty box.
I think he picked up his stopper there as well. It was on the floor. Tennant trying to get through.
Show once more at the front, trying to slow him down. Called out of play, has to let him go. Five more in the sky.
Another thing you've got to love about Ninja Panning, they're putting a really good effort. With the lack of experience, they've come all this way to compete in a World Cup tournament.
Oh, God, yeah.
They're going to take away a lot from this.
Yeah, I mean, this is only going to grow the sport in Japan. And, I mean, that's what we want. That's things like this. Yeah, okay, we've got the 15 countries that are coming here. Special shout out to members of the New Zealand Blackskates who unfortunately just couldn't make it here. They were meant to be here as well. But this is going to grow and grow and grow the sport. And that's what we want to see. Not just with the men's game, the women's game, the junior game, everything. The more Derby grows, the better it is for all of us.
El Tanant just racking up more and more points.
He's racking up the points so far, 25 on this one, Jam. Bubble makes his way to the penalty box for a track cut. And once again, the Canadians are just, it's showing the difference in experience. Yeah, the Canadian guys have been playing for some time and have just got the experience and they're getting in the right positions.
Yeah, I mean, they've also got to think Canada as a country, they like their skating in general.
Yes.
So they're very, very skilled, very experienced skaters. They don't have to worry about what's happening on their feet, you know, underneath them. They're concentrating on the opposing players.
Exactly.
And how to control them. We've seen them do some phenomenal controlling of Ninjapan's jammers.
Brilliant,
out on that
yeah.
track.
Okay, now this is the announcer's nightmare. It's
Flusterclock.
And Ikagaseyoro. I'll think that. I'll go with that. I'll just call him Ika. That will do.
I'll just call him Fluster.
Please.
Or Cluck.
Oh, nearly round the outside. Just avoided the track cut.
Lovely bit of awareness then. From watching them in their first game, I've already seen a progression in the way Ninjapan are playing and what they're doing.
Yeah, I mean, it's just the unlucky. On that time, he has got the track cut. I don't think he's realised yet.
I think there has been a little bit of a language barrier problem with the Japanese skaters and the referees.
Well, of course, English is the lingua franca for roller derby. But, of course, not everybody can speak English. You know, we've got guys obviously here from all over the world, from Japan, from Argentina, most of continental Europe, where English is not their first language.
No, and I think, though, if they're training with referees that are calling out the calls in English, it helps. But if they're not, if they don't have access to that at the moment, it does cause some problems and increases the penalties.
And as I was saying, in the meantime, oh, big hit there. I couldn't see who that was.
That was number four.
Ryochin.
Yeah. Lovely hit there from Ryochin. Trying to come in again. And the inside of turn four. Didn't quite get the lucky head in the first hit.
That's interesting. We've got Ryochin down here. I've just seen the back of his shirt as he stood near us. It's actually saying Chuck Breaker.
Yeah.
Which maybe is quite a good name.
So Jammers now standing in that penalty box for Ninjapan, waiting to come back out. Team Canada on a power jam. Canada jammer knocked to the outside.
An illegal re-entry called on. Yeah, that one. Ikagaseyoro. So I think he's going back to the box and it will start as another power jam for Team Canada. So the Men's Roller Derby Association would like to wish all the teams competing in the Men's Roller Derby World Cup the best of luck this weekend. The MRDA is the international governing body for men's flat track roller derby and wants you to join them in the growing world of men's roller derby. For more information about joining and the benefits of being part of the MRDA, visit them at mensrollerderbyassociation.com or send inquiries to info@mensrollerderbyassociation.com.
Also, another way of watching this, if you mean we're watching the feed, but you can also check us out on Instagram. If you look up the MRDWC on Instagram, there's some amazing... We've got a few people out and about in the crowd taking also, some wonderful pictures.
And also share photos of yourself watching it, your own viewing parties, because some of those will be put up on the stream during the course of the weekend. But in the meantime, Red, nice and relaxed, nice and steady, just signaling to his guys, nice and calm.
Coming in nice and casual, trying to take a nice easy step. Let's see. Moving through.
Wait,
just taking his time, just watching where those blockers are and just eyeing up the lines through. The one thing Ninja Japan really need to be working on is tightening up their walls.
But again, I mean, that's something that will come with time and experience. I mean, you see that with a lot of even the newer teams here in the UK that will be, when they first start, the walls are very fragmented. They're, you know, very loose and quite easy for an experienced jammer to pick their way through.
So Ninja Pan's jammer back out of the penalty box and coming up against the Canadian wall out of turn one.
So just going to say, we've had a picture from Wild Honey 182 of the cat, Butch, watching the roller derby.
That's awesome. That's absolutely brilliant.
So thank you, Butch, for watching online.
Well, if you care to put your paws in your pocket and donate a few quid, we'll be grateful.
Yep.
So we have a power jam again. Itagasaoro is going back to the box. I think that was a track cut.
Yep.
So this gives Red the chance to rack up even more points. 30 points on this jam so far.
I think possibly what Ninja Pan could do right now, even though the clock wouldn't stop, is maybe take a timeout.
Yeah, just sort of have a breather.
Just have a breather, and you know, this is another thing that I'm loving from Team Canada. They're giving high fives, they're shaking hands of Ninja Japan on track. They're really, really good sportsmen out there on track.
So just having a quick look, it looks like there's a slight delay, and I think possibly we have two foul outs. I think number 99, Bubble, has fouled out. And also possibly, oh no, Ikigasioro has gone back to the box. In the meantime, with what's going on, there's a little bit of chaos going on. The game's carrying on. Fluster Cluck has picked up lead jammer and has racked up another 5 points.
Good old Clucky going around there. I'm just going to call him Clucky.
It's probably safest.
Yeah. Ninja Japan with three blockers on.
Lovely hop and a skip there from Cluster Clock.
So. And we have an illegal procedure.
Illegal procedure penalty. Lovely to see Show trying to get the crowd. Oh, he's been told to go back to the bench. It did look like the number 32, Ikegesayoro, has fouled out because R4 Miyagi Wondai does have the star on his head. So it looks like we do have, unfortunately, a second foul out for Japan.
And of course, there's a reduced number of foul outs in these 30-minute games. So players and jammers have to be careful.
Of course, yeah, four penalties in these bouts and you're done. So, looking now with 8.5 minutes left, 248-3. U2 takes the jam line for Japan and he's up against Titchborne, number 66. First time I think we've seen him.
Yeah, I think it's the first time we've seen Titchborne on track as a jammer. He's quite a short, stocky little guy, isn't he?
Yeah, he is, but this is one of the great things about roller derby, whether it's for the men's or the women's, it is a sport for all shapes and sizes.
Yeah.
I mean, just look at us two for a start.
Yeah.
Those of you that know us will understand what that comment means.
Yeah. Or look online for pictures of us.
Yeah, there will be that. I'm sure we'll get some pictures put up at some point. In the meantime, somebody who was not posing for the cameras is Titch Vaughan as he's racking up the points.
Yeah, nice easy pass there, going for an outside line. Gets out. You too. Gets out of turn four. Lovely bit of and jumping over a falling Canadian blocker.
Okay, Gundam picked up a failure to reform penalty, but because he was, I think, the only blocker on track, he'll go to the box, report to the box between jams and come back. In the meantime, that penalty box is sponsored by Quad Skate Shop, Europe's original brick-and-mortar roller derby equipment supplier. Quad Roller Skate Shop has the best selection and most stock of any store on the continent. Excellent consultation services that only a fellow skater could provide. We've got all your needs covered because we love this game.
And the owners are lovely as well. They're a lovely bunch. Lovely couple of ladies.
That tends to be the way about derby people in general.
Yeah. U2 trying to make his way through in turn two. Up against the Canadian blockers.
In the meantime, it's our friend Clucky.
Oh, good old Clucky racking up some more points. 14 Canada, U2 determined to get through. Nelson holding him off at the back of the pack there. Makes his way around, then crashes into his own blocker.
He doesn't care what colour shirt you are. He's just going to try and plough his way through you. Fortunately for him, taken out and recycled all the way back by Ziggy. And again, Ziggy with a hit.
Nearly taking out Scarborough on the outside, one of the outside track refs.
Show's on his way back to the penalty box. He must be getting close to racking up the four.
Showing a lot of determination here against Team Canada, trying to find his way through, going down. No pack called.
And pack is rear, so that'll allow U2 to get through.
And finally, U2 breaks the back. The crowd is behind Ninjapan.
Absolutely.
We have just over five minutes remaining on the period clock. Score is currently standing 286-3 to Team Canada.
And Fast Girl Skates, their knowledgeable staff represent all facets of roller derby, WFTDA, USARS, MRDA, JRDA and Banked. They can relate and have what you need. Largest selection on skates and gear for everybody, men, women, juniors. It's about you.
Fast Girl Skates also stock a lot of products by Green Monster Roller Sports. They're all new this year. They've got some amazing products. And you can visit them at greenmonster.com.
Oh, we have a cut track for Miyagi Born Dai.
So, Canada with a power jam.
And it's Brad Ass that's taking the power jam. But again, Miyagi Born Dai getting a lot of support, as are all Team Japan. They really have won a lot of friends.
I mean, for anyone who's seen the pictures, apparently there's some pictures waiting around of the queue for the Team Japan merch. When that went up, the queue was phenomenal. I didn't even get a chance to get any.
I've not moved that fast since they announced it was a free buffet. In the meantime, Bradass head down, racking up the points.
Yeah, with another five-point pass and looking like he's coming around for a further 5 points. Little wiggle to the outside, turn two, and a grand slam on the board. 4 minutes remaining on the period clock. Scores 315-3. There he goes again, out the front, weaves his way through.
Made to work a little bit harder by Umasan that time, which again got the crowd going a little bit of support from Japan, and just trying to cheer them on and trying to encourage these guys on.
Weaving, spinning his way through.
Skater Blue Streak with Fast Girl Skates, designers of the Blue Streak boot with unparalleled comfort, fit, style and performance. So Umasan, who's been quite effective so far as a blocker, he's taken the star. He's going to have a jam this time for Team Japan. And nice little handshake there with number four, Stand Aside, who's got the star on for Team Canada.
I haven't seen much of him on the jammer line for Team Canada. Stand Aside pushes Ninjapan's blockers aside and gets out to pick up that lead jammer status.
I think what it is, I think Team Canada, what they're doing is just trying to give everybody a chance to jam. This is a long tournament, and throughout the course of the weekend, your main jammers may get tired, they may get injured, you may need to mix it up a bit, so getting everybody that track time now.
Team Canada recycling.
Umisan all the way back.
All the way back.
So it's the rev that's doing it.
Past that pivot line, which is sponsored by GB EMS. The awesome, awesome emergency services that we have here.
Yeah, they're the only UK RDA endorsed medical services. So, yeah, GB EMS, they are very, very good. They are pretty much the best. But there's Umisan through. He really doesn't want to get involved with stand aside. And stand aside calls it off. Decided that, I think that was quite a nice touch, because you've seen that sometimes where I think you can say that that was the douchebag rule coming into effect, and he decided not to be behaved himself. Nice to see.
I think they know that they've won this game.
Yeah.
They don't need to bring in any douchebag tactics of going jammer on jammer. They've got a big enough lead. They can see that NinjaPan are clearly new to this game. And they are putting in one hell of an effort.
And Kent starting with a run-up, but we have lead jammer for U2. He is lead jammer for Team Japan. Can they get some more points? Can they get up to double figures?
Tank recycling him back. And
there's the door. In case you can't tell, yep, that's him through.
And again, I think we're seeing incredibly good sportsmanship from Team Canada. I mean, they could be making this a lot harder for you two, but they are.
I must admit, I mean, Team Japan over the course of this weekend will win a huge amount of friends, but things like this will get Team Canada a hell of a lot of friends as well. Oh, we have an injury. Is not what we want to see. This is why we do have the EMS. I didn't see who it was that went down. So I believe it's one of the Japanese, but we're not sure what happened or what the hit was.
Went down in turn two and saw him roll himself off track.
I must admit, I didn't see the incident at all. So I don't know who it was, or as soon as I get some information, I will try and tell you. So, current score down at 3. I think it's Sho. Judging by it, yeah, it's Sho slow getting back up on his feet. But as is the way with roller derby, huge round of applause. The respect within the game, the players, the officials, off skates and on skates, the medical staff, all the crowd. Absolutely fantastic, and that is the end of the game.
Yeah, because obviously in these 30-minute games for injuries, the period clock isn't going to stop.
So that is the unofficial final score was a lot to not very many. I've just been informed something that I'm going to share with you because it is quite funny.
Yeah.
There's a guy who has the Twitter name at MRDWC, and his Twitter feed today has gone absolutely crazy, and he hasn't got a clue. He knows nothing about roller derby. So if you are tweeting us, it's hashtag MRDWC, not at MRDWC.
Yeah. Hashtag. Always remember the hashtag, not the at symbol, the hashtag symbol.
That's brilliant. Ladies and gentlemen, I have been King Crazy for my good friend here, Little Joker.
Yeah, I've been Little Joker. That was a really good game to watch. It's one of those games that really shows the spirit of this sport.
It does indeed, yeah.
Because you had the amazing sportsmanship.
Yeah, very much so. I mean, you know, Team Canada got right into that and some lovely touches there. Up right now on the quad skate shop track is Ireland versus Australia. Up next at here on 5 o'clock on the Royal Derby City track, we'll see Team England in their final bout against Sweden. So quad skate shop track right now, it's Ireland, Australia. 5 o'clock back here on this feed, it's England versus Sweden.
Yeah, we shall see you later.
See you later.
I basically haven't kissed all of my cousins, so you know, that's ace.